I could always count on having a smile on her face. She was kind, gentle, loving, full of joy and encouragement. And the more I think of her, the more I realize that she embodied the following verses in her life. And then Galatians 5:22-23, the Apostle Paul writes, "But the fruit of the Spirit is love, joy, peace, patience, kindness, goodness, faithfulness, gentleness, and self-control. Against such things, there is no law." And I believe all of us can attest to her love for whoever she met. No matter who it was, she always gave a warm and comforting hug that took away her worries. And with this love came her delight. She was always excited to hear about your life, about your pain, about your loves and dreams and hopes and desires. And her joy was evident to all who met her. And her joy was very contagious. I always remember that after I visited my grandparents, Karen and Dorothy, I was always joyful, happy, and giving, and very excited, and always running around like crazy, like little kids do. With this delight came peace. Peace that no matter what is going to happen, everything was going to be okay. She had this peace because it didn't originate from her, and it was the peace of God which transcends all understanding. It was this peace that guarded her heart and her mind in Christ Jesus, as Philippians 4:7 says. Now, Great-Grandma Dorothy had to be patient and had to exert an exuberant amount of self-control to live with Great-Grandpa Harry. Case in point, when Great-Grandpa Harry first got his new scooter, he would drive that scooter around his house recklessly. And when my family received our Christmas letter that year, Great-Grandma Dorothy wrote about how she had to impose a speed limit within the house because Grandpa Harry was speeding around with his new ride. He was slightly reckless with that, but still out of range, of course. Now, if that's not an exercise of self-control and Great-Grandma Dorothy's part, then I quite honestly don't know what it is. And there are countless other examples I believe all of us have been saying. I personally don't know the story, but we'll talk about them later. But Great-Grandma Dorothy was always kind, gentle, and good to every individual she met. And as Cody just said, she was always faithful to her husband and to her family. And it is this legacy that lives on in all of us. So in closing, the hymnist wrote in the last verse of "Be Thou My Vision," "High King of Heaven, my victory won. May I reach heaven's shores, bright heaven's sun. Heart of my own heart, whatever befall, still be my vision, O ruler of all. O God, be my everything, be my delight. Be Jesus, my glory, my soul's satisfied. O God, be my everything, be my delight. Be Jesus, my glory, my soul's satisfied." And now, more than ever, I believe that the legacy of Great-Grandma Dorothy's life is challenging us to walk the narrow path, to affirm with the hymnist as Dorothy did, "O God, be my everything, be my delight, be Jesus, my glory, my soul's satisfied." May we follow closely in her footsteps as she followed.